August 21st, 2017. A major total solar eclipse begins in the Pacific Ocean at sunrise. The shadow of the moon moves over North America from west to east. Here's what astronauts would see from the moon. The darkness created by the moon is widely visible. The small dark spot in the center is the shadow of the moon. The eclipse is total only in this small zone. But do not believe that the eclipse is not visible elsewhere. Partial, certainly, but it also offers such a good show in South and Central America. In northern Colombia, the eclipse occurs in the afternoon. In Barranquilla, while the sun goes down due west, the eclipse reaches its maximum at 3:33 p.m. local time. In Caracas, Venezuela, the eclipse reaches 61%, at its maximum, 3:45 p.m. local time. In northeastern Brazil, Cape Verde, in West Africa and Portugal, an eclipsed sun can be admired at sunset. For example, in Recife, Brazil, the sun sets northwest at 5:15 p.m., eclipsed at 40%. In Cape Verde, near the central axis, the sun sets over the sea at 6:50 p.m. northwest. Eclipsed at 80%, it promises to be spectacular. In Europe, on the contrary, the eclipse will be minimal, at best 30% at sunset in Portugal. In Mexico, the eclipse will be smaller than in Colombia or Venezuela. The sun will be hidden by up to 38% at its maximum at 1:22 p.m. local time. Across the USA and in Canada, the eclipse will be far more pronounced. In Montreal, for example, the sun will be obscured up to 66% at 2:35 p.m. local time. Unquestionably, the U.S. is the best off. From every corner of the USA, the eclipse will be very pronounced. LA at 10:20 a.m., horizon southeast, 70%. Even better, in New York, while the sun is already going down, southeast, the eclipse reaches 77% at 2:45 p.m. In San Francisco, the eclipse passes to 80%. At 10:15 a.m. local time, sun going up southeast. In Miami, ever closer to the totality band, the eclipse reaches 82% at 2:58 p.m., sun going down due west. In Chicago, located 290 miles of the totality band, the eclipse passes to 89% at 1:19 p.m. local time, due south. At this stage, the darkening of the sky is perceptible. In Seattle, 220 miles from the totality band, the eclipse reaches 93% at 10:20 a.m. local time. At 93%, the light of the sky begins to be tenuous, the shadows very sharp. But where the show is exceptional, it is in this band, between the two red lines, and particularly in the center. Because there, the eclipse is total. The sun is completely hidden up to a few minutes, the maximum duration, on the blue line. During these short moments, the chromosphere, this light looking like flowing silver hair, usually masked by the dazzling light of the solar disk, is becoming visible and can be admired by the naked eyes, even better with binoculars. On the ground, the atmosphere is unique. Animals are silent. We can see red beads of light, called Bailey's beads because of the lunar relief. We can see also some protuberances coming from the sun's activity. But at the end of the totality, be careful of your eyes with the sudden return of the sun. At the beginning and at the end of the totality, we can see an intense and fleeting glow, the diamond ring effect. At Teton Village, Wyoming, in the middle of the band, the eclipse is total during 2 minutes 20, between 11:34 and 11:37 a.m. Hopkinsville, in the north of Nashville, is located at the global maximum point. The eclipse is total there during 2 minutes 40 from 1:24 to 1:27 a.m. Both sides of the sun, we can see Jupiter and Venus. If the sky is clear, we can also see Mercury and Mars. We can imagine their path. August 21st, 2017. Look at the sky.